hangs upside down from cliffs, waiting for prey. But Klaff can't remain in this position for long because its blood rushes to its head. Yeah, that looks good. 249. Sorry, Fluffy. Jumped. That would have been bad. Xanth, I'll definitely do that. Though it's probably gonna be like maybe mid to late Saturday. My goal is after I'm done streaming is I really want to pass out. Straight ahead, try straight ahead. What's that? Vaya magic. It's so wild that we ended up randomly visiting the same gym at the same time again. What a weird coincidence. I swear I'm not just sneaking ahead of you so I can lie in wait and go, oh wow, weird. Might as well battle now that you're here. No, No, seriously, but to prove it, I won't even challenge you to battle this time. Much as I'd like to. But look at you and your Pokemon, they've definitely gotten stronger since last time. And these, add these to the mix and you'll be 100% set to go, no problem. I'll be cheering for you. I'll go train like maybe 20 Pokemon or so while you tackle the gym. Gym test, which is Sunflora Hide and Seek. Nature and the sun that nurtures it. Since Sunflora embodies these concepts, we try to gather them and take good care of them. Your job today is find the Sunflora located throughout Artisan. Remember, these Pokemon look like sun-shaped flowers. Gather up 10 of them and bring them to the Sunflora lawn, and you pass the test. I'll register the Sunflora's lawn location on your map to get you started. Turn right. Okay. Now we're going to look for Sunflora all around town. Yay. Found a Sunflora. Sunstone. Nice. Hi, Seji. Gonna drop you guys off in here. Can I do that? Apparently not. Sunflora. One more to go. Gym test passed. Yay. Well done on finding all these Sunflora. You passed the gym test with flying colors. Now please head back to the lobby at the Artisan Gym to report your result. Pleasure. Congrats. You've now earned the right to challenge the gym leader. Best of luck. I am ready to challenge him. Aw, oh, Miss Koala, thank you for giving Seji a gifted sub. Greetings, challenger. I'm going to jump from this windmill. You did well to come this far. I am Brassius, an artist specialized in grass-type Pokemon. I am also the gym leader here at the Artisan Gym. I was observing your gym test from atop the windmill, you know. The perception you displayed in finding Sunflora was truly, how shall I describe it? Yes, it was truly avant-garde. I only pray that you might demonstrate that eye for beauty in our battle as well. Enough talk, we must begin creating our collaborative work of art. I trust that you are ready. It is time for our masterpiece to take shape. Yay, Diglett leveled up. We'll keep our current Pokemon. Has promise? Yes. Let us lead this artistic endeavor and okay. To its conclusion at once. I need to touch this work up slightly. I will call it truly voodoo. Thanks, Alex. Second gem down. Avant-garde. It's evolving. Your Palmy evolves into Palmo. When its group is attacked, Palmo is the first to leap into battle, defeating enemies with a fighting technique that utilizes electric shocks. Artistic tactics you employ, the patterns of your moves, the minute details of your Pokemon's performance, everything you did was honed to perfection. Our battle was, in a word, art. Indeed, if we could not call that a word of artistry, then nothing else in this world would be labeled as such. If I were to judge your work, I would say it passes my inspection. Yes, a pass without exception. As proof of your artistic prowess, you may have my gym badge. Shall we take a photo as well? Two down. 6 to go. Level 30 and down. Okay. A favorite of mine, Trailblaze. Oh, my inspiration is overflowing as if drawn from a bottomless well. I will begin a new piece at once. You must excuse me. Farewell. Yes, that is a new thing. Well, how long did you pin it for? Okay. Pardon me, would you be the magic I've been hearing so much about? Nimona had mentioned there was a promising new face in the academy. Yes, indeed. Oh, but I do apologize. I didn't mean to startle you by addressing you so suddenly. My name is Hassel. I'm one of the Elite Four of the Pokemon League. I also teach art classes at the Academy. So do tell me, young magic, what compels you to collect these gym badges and strive to be a champion? For fun. Asked and answered. Thank you. Naturally, there is no single correct answer. All paths lead to the great crater of Paldea, as they say. You know, your friend Nimona is the youngest to achieve champion rank in all Paldean history. It is entirely possible that such great potential lies within you as well. Should you continue striving to reach champion rank, you will one day have to battle me. You would be wise to train hard starting now. It will save you from experiencing the bitter regret of defeat. Oh, and do come along to my art class sometime. I would be thrilled to have you attend. Alright. Go do that real quick. So right about here, I'm gonna let you kill all those people. As many as you can at least. Mm-hmm. That's a big one. Eating something. Escape. All right. Woohoo. Tighten down. Look at my little buddy coming through like a champ. But these Titan Pokemon are yeesh. I sure don't like having something so tough out to get me. I bet somewhere in there, more of that Herba Mystica. Oh, somewhere in here, there's more of that Herba Mystica the Titan was eating. Quick, let's have a look around before it comes back. Oh, we killed it. I don't think it's coming back. Watch your step. It's pretty dark. No way. It's right in front of us. This is one of the Herba Mystica. It's exactly how it looked in the book. We found the sweet Herba Mystica.
Hello, baby.
Hello, Kit Kat. Now then, let's see. What does the book have to say? It says here that the sweet Herba Mystica is good for gut health and that it helps aid digestion. So this is great for stomach aches too, or when you want to stimulate the old appetite. Now if I can just get him to eat some. Alright, now it's my turn to show off what I can do. You're about to taste some great cooking. I'm not saying that. Here you go, an Arvin original sandwich packed full of herbs. And I'll even give you a badge, you know, as a thank you for taking on that Titan Pokemon. I call it a Titan Badge. Made it myself, making a replica, or using a replica of the gym badges. A sandwich. What's up with that thing? It just comes out of its ball on it whenever, on its own whenever it wants. It wants the sandwich. Sure, why not? How's it been going so far? It's been going pretty good so far. We've gone through two gyms. Yeah. Man. A stretch. I can dash now. Look at that. Alright, stretch is done. Now it's time for a hydrate. Oh, water. What? Man, that's cold. Hi, Alex. I'm listening. Hydrate and stretch. Check. Done. Good to go. Am I better? Sure, I guess. What kind of a Pokemon does he have that needs to wait until there's nobody around? Hello, Magic. This is Sada. I detect that Corridon has regained some of its original power. It seems it will now be able to dash at high speeds while you're riding upon it. Okay. I wonder if... Okay. We're gonna set that as the destination. Thank you. Sounds about right. Oh, should I stop reading things? I never read because I'm awake. If that makes any sense. That makes sense. Yeah. So I have to ring the bell? Man, ain't nobody got time for that. That looks like something fun to jump down into. Sure. I need to get over there, so the best way to do that would be to... Oh. Go around. I guess that makes sense. So I came from there, so I'll go here. What do you know? attacks also level up. Let's check it out. How about, I really enjoy it, and I want to beat the game in less than 25 hours. Thanks. Tauros was caught. This Pokemon has a muscular body and excels at close quarters combat. It uses its short horns to strike the opponent's weak spots. /223. Thanks, Alex. could always do a splash attack. That's totally fine. You can put it up to 200. Did like Arceus. We'll try that. I was kind of hoping that the way that you catch Pokemon in Arceus would be the same in this game, and it is not. Catching Pokemon in this game is almost very similar to Sword and Shield. Die, but I got myself a Murkrow. Feared and loathed by many, it is believed to bring misfortune to all those who see it at night. 232. Yes.
money, I'm home!
Sis Lazar. Apparently, Sis Lazar has been allowing people to ride on its back since ancient times. Depictions of this have been found in 10,000-year-old murals. $2.95. Yeah, when I'm not live, I mute my sound alerts. Just for that reason, Kit Kat. Oh, Alex, thanks for giving us up to Zant. Let's go try and figure out. Cassiopeia here, I see you're getting close to one of Team Star's bases. I take it this means you've decided to join my operation. This, you're officially a member of Operation Starfall. Hold on a second. Does this Operation Starfall of yours have room for one more member? Who are you? The name's Clive. Oh, and how long have you been spying on us? No need to get your hackles raised. I'm a pal of our mutual friend here, isn't that right, Magic? Yeah, we are pals, actually. We're talking about going up against Team Star here. It's not something you can join in for fun. I'm well aware, I just need to sort out some unsettled business with Team Star, that's all. Besides, I tend to get jobs done well. Not that you can take my word for it, but it's true. I suppose I'm hardly in a position to refuse help. Welcome to the operation, Clive. Great, that settles it then. I think I heard your name earlier. Cassiopeia, was it? Who exactly are you? Team Star and I share some history. That's all I'll say for now. I see. In that case, I won't press you further. Good, now back to business. Let's talk Operation Starfall. Yes, what would you have us do? Simply put, I want you to raid each one of Team Star's bases, then you'll defeat the bosses of the team and put an end to their rule. put an end to their rule. You mean we need to oust these bosses from their rule somehow? That's right, Team Star is made up of 5 squads, and each of those squads has its own base. You should be able to see the front gates of one of those bases now, in fact. Ah, yes, I can see them over there. On the other side of those is the base proper. Anyway, and somewhere within that base lies one of your targets, a squad boss. Okay, I'm starting to get the idea. Well, that's just the outline. The key to the whole operation is the code that the team has to follow. If someone challenges one of the squad bosses to a battle, they have no choice but to accept. And what's more, if they just so happen to lose that battle, they must forfeit their role as boss altogether. I went ahead and issued challenges to each base under your name magic. They're basically declarations of war. Thank you. Now all of Team Star knows that we're looking for a fight. So let's say we defeat all the bosses and they step down from their roles. What happens next? The rest of the team crumbles with no one left to lead them. That's what happens. It's a solid plan, but not without wrinkles. Each base has a bunch of Pokemon inside to fend off intruders, and the bases themselves are of a considerable size. The garden variety trainer would be overrun long before they'd get anywhere near the boss. That's why your skills are essential to this operation, Magic. Defeat the Pokemon inside the base and drag the boss out from there where they're hiding. First things first, you'll need to deal with any grunts that might be guarding the front gates. And what will you be doing in the meantime? Like I said before, I have a history with Team Star. That means I can't operate out in the open. I'll back you up from afar. Alright, and what will my role be? Sorry, but I don't trust you completely just yet. For now, I'd like you to monitor the bases and act as magic support. You're a cautious one, alright, I respect that. Okay, Alex, have fun tinkling. I'll be in touch again when the plan advances to the next stage. Good hunting out there. Well, go get him, Magic. I have no idea what you mean, but if anyone asks you about me, remember this. I'm Clive, a normal academy student just like you. Nothing more, nothing less. Alright, here we go. Alright. No turning back. Let's take you out. Cassiopeia told me to scout out the fire crew's base. I thought I'd give you some backup now that I'm through, but it seems you're all set. Is that you, Carlos? Charlos? I thought so. What are you doing here? This is Charlos, the Char Cadet. He's one of the Pokemon the Academy takes care of within its grounds. And he ran off. Yes, I am. Let's take him out.